the verses. Encourage us.
Yes.
Solidify us.
Yes.
In the battle. All right, if you would please. Book of St. John, chapter number 20, and verse 24. St. John 20, 24.
But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus,
thank you, that's good, read on, very good,
was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, we have seen the Lord.
Yes.
But he said unto them, except I shall see in his hand the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe.
What a statement to say. That unless I put my fingers in his side to the nails, I'm not going to believe. Read on.
And after 8 days, again his disciples were within, and Thomas with them.
Now keep in mind, from that day, those 8 days, although with the 12, although saw the miracles, although preached himself, he didn't really, believe.
And after 8 days, again, his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst and said, Peace be unto you. Then saith he to Thomas, reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him,
My Lord
and my God.
And my God. That's good. I thought this morning in brief, the blessing of keeping a made up mind.
Amen.
Never been a time in history where you see more religious unrest, especially the minds of people. It seems to be all around everywhere you go. People are just at an unrest position. I think the axis may cover feelings, the world, Word of God. There's an axis there. I asked him, I said, why don't you want me to say? He said, the world.
My Lord.
The world.
The world.
He said, enough, the world. And others, because of the way they feel.
Yeah, right.
Certain feelings. Ideas, traditions, mores. And others, just the Word of God may not make. And it's an axis there that produces unrest. But dear, what I trust will offer today, Lord, that you might set my mind.
Yes.
It's one thing to get a mind, but you gotta keep your mind. You gotta keep it.
Yes,
it's
true.
Gotta keep it.
Yeah.
One day in Detroit, I was about 18 years old, and we had went to the store, and what foolishness, and we bought some beer and had some money, and it was ours. And Detroit's a rough city. Amen. And guys came up, and he had a sawed-off shotgun, said, give me your money, give me your beer. And we gave it to him. The devil the same way. He wanted to strip you up and take exactly what you have to do. But my friend Bill said, I'm not giving it up. I said, man, give me your money. He said, I'm not giving the money. I said, man, give me your money. I'm on this side. Give me your money. He said, I'm not giving my money. And you know what? They went on their way. Tell the devil, I'm not giving up anything to you. I'm going on what? My way. The blessing of a mind is kept made up. So many have had that mind made up years ago. But dear one, in life, things do happen. Is that right or wrong? Say amen to God.
Amen.
Life can be tough sometimes. Is that right? And it can unhinge you.
That right.
Shock you.
Come on.
And affect you.
Yes, sir.
And if our minds are not stayed made up, that can be a breeding ground for unbelief. Doris had a made-up mind. 20 years ago, she came for prayer. She was having seizures. the altar, praying a prayer, the brothers and I prayed, and God healed her. And that made her mind, look, if he did it once, he'll do it again. Let this mind be in you, which is what? There's an axis of unrest. Have you seen that to you? Feelings, how I feel, the world. You know, the world can seem so exciting, can it? It can seem so alluring and exciting and fun.
But the wages of sin is what?
Yeah. So Lord, help us into God to leave here not just getting an idea, keeping that mind.
Lord,
the devil wants to try to steal it. Because if you lose your mind,
my God.
At work this morning, there's two clients there. And so I said, breakfast time. He get up, put clothes on, walking around the house. I said, man, what? I said, man, go get some clothes on. What you walking around? I mean, and just, but he don't know it.
No.
He'll go outside down the street walking with clothes on. He don't know it. I said, Jesse, get some clothes on, man. He lost his what?
Mind.
The devil was after your mind.
You get it.
Through thoughts. Feelings.
Yeah.
And the world. My mind.
Yeah,
man. Oh, my mind. You might get another. You can get another hand operation, maybe a new heart, but when your mind is gone. So you can't perceive. You can't judge things correctly.
No.
This individual who went to that church and killed those folks, something on his mind. Charles, the same thing. What with your mind? Now you know folks don't have no gun in church. Yeah, that embrace. Well, here you come with your automatic. And you killed babies too. So what's your mind? Dear one, I hope you leave here having a mind made up, but to keep it
made up.
So when tests come, and they will, issues come, and they will, church issues, home issues, health issues, they will going to come.
It will.
But Christ said, I will come, world.
Yeah.
Read again, please, if you would.
Verse 27.
That's good. Uh-huh.
Then saith he to Thomas,
yes.
Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing.
And Thomas said, my Lord, what else?
And my God.
He was settled.
My Lord.
He said, I'm made up now. My mind's made up. I'm in for good. It took him a while. I said to reach out in a special way, but it was settled. Dear one, this morning, is your mind settled? Is your mind settled? Mark chapter 5, verse 24. And I have to give Thomas that in that. He said, look, I'm not dead yet. I don't have it yet. What's it going to take? I've got to reach and touch. If I do that, I believe. And Christ, in his mercy, in his love, he said, Thomas, reach. My Lord, my God. St. Mark 5, 24, read on, lady.
And Jesus wept with him,
yes.
And much people followed him and thronged him.
Right.
And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians,
yes.
And had spent all that she had, and was nothing better,
yes.
But rather grew worse.
Worse.
When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment.
Hold on 1 second. Let's back up a little bit. The woman, number one, has suffered many things. Have we suffered many things?
Amen.
In this world, many things. And some are still suffering even this morning.
Yeah.
You got folks here right now that are hurting this morning over issues and situations. Yeah. Right now. You know what it is to suffer.
True.
Number two, the physicians let her down.
Yeah.
Like they do. Did you all know that?
True.
Last year, what the statistics indicate, 30,000 botched operations.
My Lord.
We had a couple doctors go here in the past. One of them was doing operations without any insurance.
Yeah.
I said, man, what are you doing? The other one was selling pills through his office. He's in jail now. They call it the practice of medicine, and it is. You know, before you take a medication, find out what the side effects are first, okay? You might be a little bit surprised at what they do.
Those side effects. It could be worse than the actual issue.
So she let down by the physicians, and she was broke. She spent all she had. And no doubt she felt cheated, tricked. Spent my money and got nothing for it. And she was worse than the first.
My God.
And then when all those things were on her, I could see her now, brother, broke, health broken, sad, sick, nothing, and by herself. I don't read about a father or a mother or a child, just by herself, crawling on the ground. Get to Jesus. Verse 27, read on, please.
When she had heard of Jesus,
yes,
came in the press behind,
all right,
and touched his garment.
Yes.
For she said,
if
I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole.
Her mouth laid up. She said, I got to crawl, I do that.
My Lord.
If I'm broke, I go through that. If I'm sicker, I go through that. If I'm by myself, I go through that. Because my mind is made up. I'm going to keep it made up.
Amen.
If I can just touch the hem of his garment, I'll be healed. Mm-hmm. And he said, who touched me? He said, somebody touch me. He said, wait a minute. He said, wait. They said, Lord, you're being threatened. Somebody has touched me. The power's gone from me.
Yes.
Somebody touched me.
Amen.
Somebody got through.
Amen.
They had a mind made up to not give up.
Amen.
To not go back.
Amen. Amen.
To not leave church.
Yeah.
Your mind made up permanently.
Amen.
Is your mind made up permanently?
Amen.
I hope somebody got help of
it.
He said, no, no, I don't care about that. I don't care about that.
That's right.
My mind is made up.
Oh, yeah.
Say what you want.
Amen.
Do what you will.
Amen.
My mind made up permanently.
Amen.
Permanently. Virtue going out of me. Because somebody's what? Touch me. Let's say it on three. One, two, three. Somebody what?
Touch me.
One more time. Somebody what?
Touch me.
Thank you, Jesus. Somebody.
Mama.
They came low. Thank God. Like a stealth. And she got a hold of me. And she was healed instantly. Didn't want to let nobody hold you back from Christ. Let no spirit hold you back from Christ.
Yeah.
Let no preacher hold you back from Christ.
Yeah.
Don't let yourself hold you back from Christ, my God.
Yeah.
Make your mind up.
Yeah.
Thou will keep him in perfect peace.
Yeah,
whose mind is what?
Stayed on him.
Stayed on him. Yes, her mind was made up. James chapter 1, verse 6. Read on, please. James chapter 1, verse 6.
But let him ask in faith.
Right, say amen.
Amen.
Can I have one say amen over there?
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. On my left,
say amen.
Yes, man.
I heard two. A couple more seconds. One. Two. When you finally say amen.
Amen.
I'll accept that.
Faithful,
read on.
But let him ask in faith.
Yes.
Nothing wavering.
Nothing wavering.
For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea,
yes,
driven with the wind and tossed.
Go ahead, verse, read on.
For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord.
Yes.
A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
A double-minded what?
Man.
Is what?
Is unstable.
In some ways.
In all his ways.
In all his ways.
Every way.
He's unstable.
That's right.
You remember Jacob? talks to his sons, he says, thou art unstable as what?
Lord.
Unstable. Unsure. My God, no one. Can't connect the dots right. Upholding 1 minute, take it down the next. Unstable. Read on, please, if you would, verse 8. Read.
A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
In all his ways. Because what happened?
He's not, his mind is not fully made up.
True.
And the devil can bring him down.
That's right.
Doubt has to find a place to relax. It's got to find a place to sit down. It's got to find a place to make his home somewhere.
That's right.
And when a person's mind is not made up, he'll come in and have a seat.
That's right.
He'll relax and do his demonic damage. But when the mind is kept made up, no room for it.
And then when doubt can bring fear to it, you all know that it brings fear to it. It brings fear. And fear has what?
Torment.
And he that fear, not be perfect in love. Because perfect love does what? Cast what? Out fear. Let's move on, please. Another verse. Is that James? Read that last part one more time, please. Just one more time.
A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
So, you know what, again, that's a breeding ground for unbelief. Jesus said, when I return, shall I what?
Find faith.
On the earth.
Did he say on the earth or in the earth?
Right.
Shall I find faith?
And you know, he's looking for some faith. He's trying to find somebody who will believe in him. You know, the prophet told the first king of Israel, he said, obedience is what? And so, but if my mind is not kept made up, I may or may not. I may not do it now. I may not do it at all. I may defer it. I might change it or do part of it. But Abraham's mind was made up. So I want your son, whom thou lovest.
My God.
That's right. Right. And the next morning he was gone with his son to the mountain to do what God had said. Because his mind was made up. Now I'm sure on the way. Think about your child. They're maybe 12, 15 years old, you're walking hand in hand. And he doesn't know what's going on for the most part. And, amen, come here, Mike.
Yes,
you all are walking hand in hand.
Right.
Up to the mountain.
Yeah.
And you know what's going to happen. Because you're going to do it. You're going to do it. You're going to slip through.
Right.
Juggle the vein right there, you're going to sit there. Mm. And you're thinking, and then your son said, Dad, we got the wood.
Yeah, right.
And we got the knife.
Make it make sense.
For where to sacrifice. Now, only a parent could feel that.
Right.
That would be the truth. Your child said, now we got A, B, for where C. Abraham said, what? The Lord will do what?
Bye. There you go. Right.
You want God to provide for you. God will provide for you.
Amen.
Someone here might feel God will not. No. That's what the devil is. God will provide for you. My God shall supply what? All your need. According to what?
Richard Angle.
26:3 Isaiah, please. Start at verse 1.
Yes.
I'm going to pray a few moments. Lord, don't let my mind shift in this storm. Lord, don't let my mind begin to react the way it ought not to react.
Amen.
Lord, don't let me know. Prejudge, say, I shouldn't be judging at all. Maybe
my
judging
God.
At all.
Yes, Lord.
But Lord, I want to do the right thing at the right time.
Yes.
Many have lost it.
Yes.
Many
they backslid on that.
Oh, dear God.
Timing is off. Your timing is off. That's when you're off. The right thing at the what? Right time. It came to pass. If you want, some things take time.
Before we pray, you know the story, of course, of how the little farm boy had an interview.
Wasn't hatched yet.
He could hear the little chicken in there trying to get out. So he thought, I'm going to help him. So he broke the shell to get him out.
And the chick got out and died. Because, see, breaking the shell gives him strength in the beak.
Sure.
That air coming in slowly helps him to dry his wings off. So all of that is relative to a strong chicken. But he's going to do it now. Something got to wait.
Wait on the Lord. And again, I say what? Wait.
That's right.
There was a sister here who wanted to get married badly. And so she went on the computer and sent this fellow across the country a picture of her. And she was dressed in her array. Guess who turned her in? Her own son. He said, well, look at this. My mother sent that off. I said, what? I said, you're modest, modest. He said, yes. She didn't want to wait. Well, she got one, but, well, you know how the story goes. Read on, please.
In that day.
It didn't end well. Read on.
In that day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah.
Land of Judah.
We have a strong city.
A strong city.
Salvation will God appoint for walls and bulwarks. Open ye the gates.
Yes.
That the righteous nation which keepeth the truth may enter in.
All right.
Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace. Whose mind is stayed on thee.
Why is that?
Because he trusteth in thee.
Trust in the Lord.
Forever.
With all thine heart. And lean what?
Not unto thine own understanding.
And all thy ways do what?
Acknowledge.
He should do what?
Direct thy path.
It did not in order to work. That verse 3, please.
Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusteth in thee.
We are still the church.
We will go, listening, forward. Still the church.
True.
We'll go on.
True.
Let's forget about the things which are what?
Behind us.
Till the church, still what? Keep pressing what?
Right.
Let's go on.
Amen.
Let's go up. Sure. He called Moses.
Come on up to the mountain. Thank you. Elijah went up twice in the chariot and in the mountain. He called John. Come up hither. And calling you and I. Keep on going. Set your mind like a flint.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
And you'll be all right. Oh, you'll be all right. So if you want to pray, you can answer to God. Lord, I want to keep this mind.
Yes.
I don't want to break. Others are broken, but they're broken. They're broken. And many are broken permanently.
Yes.
That's what's so shocking, permanently break.
Yes.
But no, Lord, keep my mind.
Yes.
Let's stand this afternoon. And stand, and if you wish to pray at the altar at your seat, whatever is best for you. Jesus said not to always pray, not faint. The effectual, fervent prayer, the righteous man, availeth much. And prayer works. Do you all know prayer works?
Amen.
Well, let's work.